Hello everyone, welcome to Surya InfoEdge. In this session, we'll create repositories. If you have a Red Hat server installed and you don't have access to official Red Hat network server repositories, then you can create your own repositories. First, you need packages to put into the repository. For that, I have Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6.1. In this, I have packages folder. Here you'll find all the packages. First, we have to copy this packages folder to our virtual machine. Start with open Oracle VirtualBox. Select the machine in which you want to copy packages folder. Then click on settings, shared folder, add new shared folder, select the shared folder you want, desktop, Red Hat Enterprise Linux, packages. After selecting this folder, make it auto mount and permanent. Click OK and you are done. Now open this machine, but we cannot see that folder over here because there's one more step which you have to perform. First, we have to come out of scaled mode, Control C, go to device and insert guest edition CD image. Once you run this CD image, it is going to place that shared folder on your desktop. Okay. And next, run this. It will take a little time to run. Once it is complete, you will see your folder on the desktop. So meanwhile, it's working. We will switch the machine as it is going to take little time. It is just started VirtualBox guest edition installation and it is going to take time to install. Let's switch to machine where we already have that folder. Now on this machine you can see this folder is already there. Now we have to perform first step, that is make a directory where you can copy this folder. I have already done that. So if you want to do that, I'll show you this step. The reason for doing that is for copying huge number of packages takes a lot of time. So I've already copied the data and kept in that directory. So the first thing what I'm doing is I'm going to show you the steps which you have to perform. The first one is mkdir inside root create a directory. The name of the directory what we have selected is repo. After creation of this directory, you have to copy the data. So mkdir slash repo. This is the directory which I have created. After creation of this directory, you have to copy data from root, media, sf packages, everything from there to root repo. As there are many packages, it's going to take some time. So once you run, so the number of packages will be copied to repo. Now we have created a directory. The next step is to create a repository. For that, we have to first install two softwares, RPM and IVH. Delta RPM, and once you press tab, you should get the complete command. But as we are not in the directory, we are not getting this software over here on the desktop. It is not in the desktop, so we have to first go to the directory. So the step will be cd repo. Once we go inside repo, we'll get that software. The command is Red Hat Package Manager install verbose hash. The software which we have to install is Delta RPM. Delta RPM and Python Delta RPM are required for create repo software, and create repo software is required to create a repository out of your directory. After installation of Delta RPM and Python Delta RPM, we can now install create repo software. Once it is installed, we can create repository out of repo directory. Once you run this software, it is going to create repository out of repo. This command is going to take time, as there are so many packages available which will be included in the repository. Once this command is completed, all 2977 packages will be part of your repository. I have already completed this task, hence I'm going to stop and we'll perform the next one. Now the next is, we have to tell yum configuration file about this repository. So we are going to stop here. Just close the terminal and open a new one. Right click and again open the terminal and open yum.repos.d directory. Inside that, create a configuration file. We'll create name this configuration file as myrepo.repo. Extension .repo is compulsory, otherwise yum will not be able to understand. Write these lines in the configuration file: name, base URL enabled, and gpg check. The important, most important one is base URL. Here you are providing your configuration file name, that is file colon slash 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 repo. Save this file, escape colon wq exclamation sign and enter. Once this is done, you can check whether yum is accepting that repository or not by repo list command. So yum has replied that there is one my repo named repo list which is having 2977 packages. This means if you want to install anything, you can just write yum install and the name of the package, and yum is going to get that package from this repository. With this, we've completed creation of the repository. Thank you.